You can think of local history as your own personal version control system. It can help you to track your changes locally, revert changes, and recover deleted files. Let's take a look at how it works. There's no keyboard shortcut for local history, so you can right-click on a node or file and select Local History, Show History. IntelliJ IDEA will show you the file or files in this case that have changed in your history. It also includes labels for important events such as a build or a test run result. You can restore deleted files with revert selection, and you can double-click any file to get a diff view. In this diff view, you can see the changes from the base file and then your changes from that point in time. So you can revert new lines, deleted lines, and changed lines. Back in our local history dialog, we can see that there is a label stating failed test, but the file is not appearing in the dialog on the right. That's because it's in our test directory rather than main, which is what we selected for local history. Let's go to our test directory and look at the local history for just that file. This shows us that the test was passing, but then something changed, and when we reran the test, it was failing. When we look at the diff view, we can see what the offending change is and revert it. Let's check that test runs again. Great. Local history also supports your labels. Let's say you're about to start a bug fix or refactor some code. In this case, you can select a node or file and then right-click and select Local History, Put Label. For example, fixing bug 9523. Local history will then give you an audit trail so that once you've fixed the bug, you can see which files you changed after you put that label in. That is, the files you changed fixing that bug. Local history tracks meaningful changes you make in your project, and it can be very helpful for recovering work in the event that your machine crashes or you need to roll back some code that perhaps has had some unintended consequences. However, it is cleared when you reinstall IntelliJ IDEA. It also has a retention period and maximum size, so changes are not guaranteed to persist. As always, please use a version control system for your code in addition to local history. They're both very helpful in preventing you from losing your work. Thanks for watching.